After 3.5 months back on home soil, Dr. Kylie Moore-Gilbert reflecting on an ordeal that lasted 804 days, the reality of which still hasn't fully sunk in.
It feels like it happened to someone else. It doesn't feel like my life.
The Australian academic was arrested at Tehran Airport in 2018 as she was about to board a flight back to Australia. She was later convicted for being a spy and sentenced to 10 years in prison. In her first sit-down interview since being freed, the 33-year-old revealed she was subjected to weeks of solitary confinement.
It's psychological torture. I felt if I have to endure another day of this, you know, if I could, I'd just kill myself.
Also beaten and forcibly injected with tranquilizer.
Her bravery, her courage, her resilience is something extraordinary.
While thankful for her successful release, she's also criticised the government's diplomatic strategy to have her freed.
The line being run by the government was that trying to find a solution diplomatically behind the scenes with Iran was the best approach.
An approach the Islamic studies lecturer felt wasn't working, saying she urged her family to go public.
I'm not convinced that the quiet diplomacy argument stacks up.
The Prime Minister, though, has defended the strategy, saying quiet diplomacy was the best option.
Kylie Moore-Gilbert obviously can't be aware of all of the things that the government has been involved in to secure her release over a long period of time.
Back in 2019, the Australian public were unaware Dr. Moore-Gilbert had already been imprisoned in Iran for a year. She says when her identity was made public, her conditions and treatment in detention improved. But experts say Iranian authorities don't respond well to such public diplomacy.
In the past, in many cases, megaphone diplomacy has not really worked with Iranians. And therefore, I think pursuing the matters through quiet channels of diplomacy has proved more effective.
In 2008, photojournalist Nigel Brennan was held hostage in Somalia for 15 months. He says each case is unique, but media attention can add to an already volatile situation.
The more players, the more complex a negotiation can be, and obviously the less you want that in the media so that someone doesn't slip up and basically throw a spanner in the works.
And even in her darkest moments, Dr. Moore-Gilbert saw some things with absolute clarity.
I always knew I would survive and I would come back.
Pablo Viñales, SBS World News.